love me, Lord.
Well, hello, everybody, and welcome. Welcome to Serve at Home, our first ever Serve at Home. And I'm broadcasting to you from the Serve at Home studios, or as my kids call it, our playroom. And my name is Peter. I have the privilege of getting to be a part of this with you tonight. And we got lots of great stuff happening. And as hard as it was to postpone Serve this year, I am so glad that we at least get a chance to celebrate together some of the good stuff that God has done in our lives and hopefully in the lives of your community today as you were serving. A couple of housekeeping things. One is for your best experience of the live stream, I would suggest switching to speaker view. If you're not already in speaker view at the top right of your Zoom screen, you should have that option, and I'd suggest choosing that. Also, feel free to use the chat. There will be opportunities during the live stream where we will be asking you to jump on the chat. And I'm just realizing, I don't know if the chat is there. Oh yeah, there it is. Okay, great. We'll be asking you to jump on the chat for the game later and some other input. So please do jump on that when you want, or as you feel you want to talk about whatever's happening with Serve at Home. Lastly, and probably most importantly is, all right, the chat is up and working, is please do mute your audio and stop your video. That will help with the whole experience. As much as we would love to see you, it'll be better for everybody if only those who are helping lead us through this whole live stream are on the screen. So please do keep yourself muted and hide your video. Without further ado, I just want to say thank you for serving. All over Western Canada today, groups were serving their local communities. And, oh, chat is even working up in Whitehorse. Beautiful. Hello, Whitehorse. I asked you to use the hashtag ServeAtHome2020, ServeAtHome2020 on Instagram to post some of your photos. Many of you have already done that, and we'll look at those photos at the end. But if you haven't already done that, someone from your group who took some photos, hop onto your Instagram account and post a couple of photos using the hashtag ServeAtHome2020. And we'll look at those photos together in a little bit. And above all else, thank you for serving. You know, Serve is such a special event every year because we get to go into a local community and pour out the love of Jesus through serving. And amazing things happen as we do serve those local communities. And I'm trusting that you did that today. Tonight, we're gonna have an opportunity to hear from a whole bunch of people. And I'll introduce a few of them in just a second. But as we get into this evening together, I'd like to open with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, I am so grateful for all of the people who have served today, Lord, in their local communities, for those who are serving on a regular basis, for those who decided to jump on this live stream. Maybe they didn't serve today, but that's okay. We're so grateful for them. Everyone who's jumped in, who loves Serve, who wanted to be a part of this evening, I pray that you would bless it, that your spirit would be present among us, Lord, even as we are separated by thousands of miles. You are present with us, Lord, and we invite you in. Pray in your name, amen. Amen. As all of you know, we've got amazing music as a part of Serve every year, and for most years, that's been because of an amazing team that's come. And Fraser Campbell, as many of you know, I'm not going to talk to you about his many accomplishments because you know what? Those are not as important as this. He absolutely loves Serve. He loves being a part of it and takes a week most every summer to travel wherever Serve is being held, bringing a group of musicians with him to help lead us into worship. And I'm so thrilled that this evening we get a chance to have Fraser lead us in worship, even as it is a live stream. So Fraser, I welcome you to lead us into worship.
Hi, guys.
It's so good to be here with you. We are so stoked to be here. This is Michaela. This is Amelia. You guys probably remember them if you've been to Serve. And we are going to do some worship together. So I want to encourage you guys to sing along. I think that's all that needs to be said. So feel free to sing along with us, and we'll have some fun.
I'll raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. I'll raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I'll raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. I'll raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm, louder and louder. Gonna hear my praises roar. Up from the ashes, hope will arise. Death is defeated.
Disappointed
when we found out that we weren't actually going to be on location this year for Serve, but we're actually really excited as well too. When we found out that we get to join you guys online for this event, and we really miss seeing all of your faces and being with you. And the actual musical worship is only a small portion for us of what Serve is all about. And being with you guys, serving with you guys, and fellowshipping is also so important to us. But we are so lucky and so blessed that we get to do this kind of thing still. And we're in a day and age where we can meet together this way. We have a lot of challenges. We face a lot of challenges in our daily lives. A lot of challenges are new to us this year, new to the world this year. Things like the COVID whole epidemic and everything else that kind of comes along with that, and along with the daily struggles we have. But we do have a God that is stronger and mightier than and anything that we can face that would maybe bring fear and lack of hope into our lives. And so we're going to sing a song. Hopefully some of you recognize this one. But it's just basically talking about how God is, he's a provider. He makes ways for us. He is a rescuer, and he gives us hope and future.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are the way maker, miracle worker, promise king, light in the darkness, my God.
You never stop.
Light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper. Light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Amen. God, we just thank you that you are a miracle worker, that you are working in each one of our lives, in our loved ones' lives, that you're protecting us, that you're holding on to us, and that you have all of this world in your hands. We just thank you for that. We thank you that we have a hope that we can rely on, that it's much greater than any other hope we could possibly have. We thank you for that, God. Amen. Amen. Peter, I'm going to pass it back over to you. Peter looks extra handsome, by the way, online.
I had a beard just like that until about 5 minutes before we started, and it's just gone. It fell off, fell right off. How good is it to have worship together and worship together, but apart, and it's sweet. And I'm excited to say that we're going to have another time of worship later with Fraser. And so I invite you, in preparation for that, if there's a song that you'd like to hear, we're opening up to suggestions. So use the chat and to write a song that maybe is one of Fraser's originals that you guys love from years at Serve, or another worship song, and just put those in the chat. List a couple, whatever you want, and we'll take a look at those, and Fraser will choose from those later on. Just as a reminder, if you're just joining us, please do choose speaker view as your option at the top right of your Zoom. If you haven't already, that'll be the best experience for you, so you don't see all these empty blank squares around your screen. Earlier, we had some music as we were leading into it, and I just want to let you know that is Torrin Wells. The music is before the live stream started. Torrin Wells and new album, Citizen of Heaven. If you liked it, great. If you didn't like it, it's still Torrin Wells, Citizen of Heaven. But I always love to let you know of some great music that's out there that can be something that you can play at Youth Group and download yourself. We're going to have an opportunity tonight to hear from someone that I've grown very close to over the last year, year and a half, and that is Steve Somala-Grant. Steve was brought on to direct our brand new gap year experience called Curios. And I'm so excited for you to hear. We've had tons of ups and downs in the planning of it this year with COVID and all the rest, but we are moving forward with Curios this fall. And Steve is someone, he's a humble guy, but I just want to let you know, we are incredibly fortunate that God has brought us such an incredible man of God who has a passion for seeing young adults grow to make Jesus Lord over every area of their lives. He's become a really, really good friend, and I love working with him, and I'm excited for him to share a little bit of what's happening this year and in years to come with Curios.
Well, thanks, Peter. I love you too. It's great to be here with all of you. I spent a little bit of time this afternoon praying for you all while you were out in your service projects, and I asked the Lord if there was something he wanted me to tell you. And I felt like Jesus said very quickly, tell them how much I delight in them. And the fact that you would take the time to be in your communities and serving, and just this brilliant smile on God's face as you've done that. I felt like he wanted me to tell you that. And then he said, and remind them of what I told all of my followers before I died in John 14, that I will never leave you alone. He said, yeah, I got to go to a place, but I will send you the Holy Spirit to be with you forever, to guide you and to comfort you. And I felt like Jesus wanted me to remind you that in the midst of all the things that are going on around us, which is crazy and we all know it, and sometimes there's anxiety and fear and uncertainty and all those things, Jesus said, you're never, ever alone. I'm with you always to the end of the age. So be encouraged. Fraser, what you led us in worship there was absolutely the same thing that I felt God was saying all afternoon. He is with us. And in response, he asks us to love him with all of our heart, all of our soul, all of our mind, all of our strength, and then to love others as ourselves. And Curios that Peter just mentioned is a brand new gap year program that's been created to help young adults learn how to do that for our entire lives. We've just started the group of churches that we're a part of loves you as young adults and youth so much that we're creating this experience. It's going to be 8 months long, 7.5 months long. All about, we're going to worship together. We're going to study scripture together. We're going to learn about our gifts. We're going to learn what it means to live in community. We're going to learn about the church. And we're going to do that while we travel across Western Canada, while we spend a couple of weeks outdoors, in outdoor adventure weeks. And while we go cross-culture to Costa Rica for 7 weeks to learn from our partners there what it means to live with Jesus as Lord and what it means to love others as ourselves. That's the plan. There's lots of details. It's on our website, curios.ca. If you Google Curios Christian Gap Year Program, you'll get there. And we're launching, as Peter said, we're launching right away. Now, the program I've just described is what's going to happen in 2021. With everything going on in the world, we've had to make some changes for this year. Those are also on our website. Most of you, I think, are probably in high school, maybe junior high. So the program that we've designed is something that will be available to you. If you're a youth leader or if you know somebody not certain what to do this fall, this September, we've reimagined Curios for this season. If you go to the website, Curios Reimagined, we're going to do 6 weeks together. We're going to travel Western Canada where we can, and we're going to study scripture and learn how to love God and continue that for a while online. So all those details are there on the website. Thank you for the time today, and thank you for serving.
Thank you, Steve. Yeah, once again, that website is curios.ca, and applications are open for the Reimagined Experience, which is starting in September, and there's still 3 spots available, I think, for this September. If you're a young adult and you, like Steve said, are looking for something different this fall. I know that a lot of schools and plans are just not what you thought they might be. And then we're also taking applications already for the year 21-22. So if you're looking for not this school year, but what God might have for you the following one, please do check out curios.ca. Well, I'm really excited because last year at Serve, we had a lot of fun together during our evening sessions. And a big part of that is a very, very fun friend. Oh, who's right there? And her name is Hannah Juris. And I asked Hannah, I said, we can't have a Serve at Home live stream without some crazy, wacky games with Hannah. And so Hannah, I'm gonna pass it to you for whatever you have in store for us. I am personally very, very excited.
Oh dear, I think that might be selling myself a little bit too excited, but that's okay. I wish that we were all in person. I'm staring at a big garbage bag full of pool noodles, and I wish that we could have like a game where I would watch you all like run around a sanctuary, like banging each other with one. I would have that as great entertainment, but unfortunately, the Rona is out and about, so we're gonna do things a little bit differently. So this is the point of the evening where every person needs a piece of paper and a pen, because you're not only fighting for ultimate bragging rights and eternal glory, you're actually competing for a really good prize. And I mean it, it's a good one. And so we will take into account who wins this section of the evening. And we'll announce a winner this evening, and Peter and I will be in touch with you because you actually get a really good prize that will make you really popular at youth group. So make sure you have a piece of paper and a pen on you because we're gonna do a little bit of a trivia time, okay? So it's hard to tell because I have no idea if you're ready or not. So let's hope this works. I don't know if my video is lagging, so just gonna wait for Peter to call me if it's bad. But yeah, we're gonna do a trivia. So I hope you have a piece of paper, a pen. If you don't have that and your leaders let you have a phone, you can use it on your phone. But this is very much an honor system. So no cheating, okay? I don't like cheating. I will come to your neighborhood when I'm allowed and I will, cheaters, okay? Oh, Peter did text me. He said that I'm doing great. Okay. So here is your first question of the trivia round. In 2018, where was Serve? It's really easy. I'm wearing the t-shirt. Can you see it? It's backwards. Oh no, yeah. It was my favorite Serve, so you should know the answer to this one. We'll do a bit of an answer, like I'll give you the answers at the end. But that one, if you've been around the block a few times, you should know the answer to that one. Okay, question number two. In Weyburn last year, we had a theme. What was it? This is tricky. You're gonna have to think back to the messages that we listened to. It's a good one. It's just one word of a theme. And it was like a fruit of the spirit. We talked about giving. Should be a clue. Keep thinking about that. Since we were supposed to be in the Yukon, hello, Yukon friends. I wish we could be with you. I'm going to give you a little bit of some Yukon trivia because, well, we should learn about a place we're supposed to be in. Okay, so this is the first question. This is question number three, but the first question about the Yukon. They're probably going to win this section, but that's okay. They might not know. The Yukon claims that they have the smallest desert in the world. How big is it? Is it, don't worry, I'll give you multiple choice. Is it A, 1.6 square kilometers, B, 2.3 square kilometers, or C, 6.7 square kilometers? Okay, so the smallest desert in the world, do we think that it is 1.6, 2.3, or 6.7 square kilometers? I think it's Carcross, how you say the desert. Anyway, that's their desert. I'm from Kamloops. That's a desert city. Anyway, true or false? Question number four. The Yukon has more moose than people. Side fact, this is definitely true in New Zealand. There are more sheep than people in New Zealand. Didn't know if you needed to know that, but now you know that random piece of information. But for the Yukon, do they or do they not have more moose than people? True or false? More moose than people. Okay. Question five is you get to pick a number between 1 and 20. Really hope I'm not going too fast. So pick a number between 1 and 20. How many of Canada's tallest mountains are in the Yukon? Okay, you have to answer 1 to 20. Because out of the top 20, Yukon has quite a few, actually. So there's your helpful hint on that one. Between 1 and 20, how many of Canada's tallest mountains are in the Yukon? Number six, what is the Yukon's national bird or provincial bird, their official provincial bird? Helpful hint, I'm gonna give you multiple choice. Is it A, stellar jay, which is different than a blue jay, B, a gray falcon, all about the colors, or C, a raven? Okay, so a stellar jay, a gray falcon, or a raven. Here's an incredibly random question for number seven. How many cherry blossoms are in this little jar? I'll give you a hint. There's two less than before because I definitely ate some while Steve was talking. I was listening, but I definitely ate a cherry blossom. There's more than 10. See? Take a guess. I know this is impossible. And you're like, Hannah, what are you doing to us? And I'm like, listen, this is how I'm torturing you because I can't hit you with a pool noodle or make you do really ridiculous things. So I'm just asking you a question that you probably won't know the answer to. I'll let you listen. I'll give you a hint. It's under 60 and it's definitely more than 10. This is how we are going to find our winner. How many are in here? Oh, my computer's telling me things. Okay. So later on in this evening, you're going to hear from our friend Louise. And so these next trivia questions are related to what she's going to talk about. And I know that some groups in particular did some really tough work today and they did some fundraising. So here's some helpful information for you as well, because we're going to talk about toilets. True or false? The average person spends 3 hours and 9 minutes on the toilet each week. 3 hours and 9 minutes. True or false? Okay, that was question number 8. Question 9, true or false? 1 in 4 people drop their phones in the toilet. True or false? True statement, I've dropped my phone in the toilet. Not this one, the one before. So 1 in 4, is that too high? Is that too low? You tell me. Okay. I'm gonna go really quickly over those questions. So in case you didn't have a piece of paper in the beginning, I'm gonna go over the first 9 questions because the last one is a little bit different and fun. So back to the beginning. Question number 1, which city hosted CERV in 2018? Should be very obvious by now. 2, last year in Weyburn, we had a theme for the week. What was it? 1 word. UConn trivia. Number 3, UConn claims to have the smallest desert in the world. How big is it? 1.6, 2.3, or 6.7? True or false? The UConn has more moose than people. 5, pick a number between 1 and 20. How many of Canada's tallest mountains are in the UConn? 6, what is the UConn's official bird? A stellar jay, a gray falcon, or a raven? Number 7, the one you'll all hate me for. How many cherry blasters are in here? And true or false for number 8, the average person spends 3 hours and 9 minutes on the toilet each week. And number 9 is true or false, 1 in 4 people drop their phones in the toilet. Okay, so hopefully you have your answers written down for those first ones. Number 10 is a little bit different. It's 2 parts. And the first part of this question, you're going to need to choose either greater than 30 seconds or less than 30 seconds. So I have a friend and I'm giving her 1 minute to do a task. And we're gonna guess if she's really fast or really slow. And you don't even know what I'm gonna ask her to do. And you don't know who this person is or if she's gonna be really good at it. So you just have to guess right now, kind of like tossing a coin in the air, if she's going to be less than 30 seconds or more than 30 seconds. You need to think about that. And then the second part of the question is, for all the glory, is to guess how long it actually will take. So you could guess 46 seconds. You can guess 9 seconds. You can guess, any number between 0 and 60. Hint, I would definitely guess more than 1, but that's all I'll give you, okay? So, this is my friend. Come join me. She's from White Rock. Can you tell everyone your name?
Hi, I'm Chloe.
This is Chloe. And she doesn't know this. I just told her she had to be good at words. And you'll recognize this because, you know, I'm predictable. We're going to call my family. I think everybody is home. They've told me they're all home. So if they don't answer the phone, clearly I'm unloved. But I'm going to give her a word. And she has 60 seconds to get whoever answers the phone to guess the word. And so this is where you have to guess. Is she going to be faster than 30 seconds or slower than 30 seconds? And then for all the glory, you're going to want to guess how long it's actually going to take her, okay? So I'm going to put them on speakerphone and hope that this works. The word that you have to get my family to guess, I don't know who it's going
to
be.
To guess or to say
it. You have to get them to say it. Okay. But you cannot say the word.
Yeah.
And you can't say any part of the word. I won't even tell them that it's not me. That's on you. So we're going to see who answers, and you have to get them to guess milestone.
Milestone.
Come close.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi, I just wanted to ask you a few questions.
Sorry, who is that?
I'm Hannah's friend, Chloe.
Oh, okay. And who do you want to talk to, Chloe?
Or just you. Calling okay. You, so... Yeah?
Okay, sure.
So, in your life, what was getting Hannah like? What's getting Hannah...
Oh, what was getting Hannah like?
Like...
Twenty seconds.
Oh my goodness. Like Hannah being born, what's like that part of your life? What would that be called?
An important moment in my life.
10 seconds.
Yeah, important. You know, what was it like? Was it like a
What was it like for me?
So what would that be called, that moment?
Call that moment.
Sorry, Dad, you lost. Bye!
It's so hard.
So, if you guessed greater than, you won. I'm not really sure what to do about the whole time thing, because she didn't get it. So if you had guessed 60 seconds, we'll give you the point. Thanks, Chloe.
Yeah, you chose the wrong person.
She got my dad. My poor dad had no idea what was happening. My dad was supposed to come to serve too because he loves White Horse and wants to come. So he's actually going for work next week. So maybe he'll have second doubts, more doubts about going back to White Horse after this. Just kidding. He probably loves you, White Horse. Okay, so I'm going to go through all of the answers and hopefully we have a clear winner. What I'll get you to do, leaders or main point person, whoever's in charge of the laptop and whose account you're using for serve, if you can just drop in the chat what the highest total of points was for your team, that way we can track who has the winner for tonight. So let me go through all the answers for you guys. In 2018, me and my friends hosted serve in Kamloops. So the first answer is Kamloops. Second, I really hope somebody remembered this, but the theme in Weyburn last year for serve was generosity. I heard White Rock downstairs, they're like, oh! So, oh, somebody was paying attention. The Yukon's smallest desert is the smallest number, 1.6 square kilometers. So that was A for number three. Number four, true. They have more moose than people. Who'd have thunk? That'd be really fun if you could do like a youth group event with moose, except they're wild and we need to protect them. But like, how fun? The answer for the tallest amount of mountains is 17. The Yukon has 17 of Canada's tallest mountains and we don't get to see any of them. I mean, I'm in BC right now, so there's quite a bit, but we don't even have three. Anyway, Yukon, you're just showing off. So the answer for that was 17. The Yukon's official bird was C, a raven. Stellar Jay is BC's, and a gray falcon is actually Ontario's. So there you have it. In my jar of cherry blasters, which I'm gonna give to Chloe because she was a champ, there was 42. But then I ate one and she ate one before we started. So there was 40 when I asked you the question. There's 40 cherry blasters in this little container. Did anyone get that? I have no idea. Oh, Nilbay, your screen froze. The theme last year was generosity in Weyburn. I got you. Okay, so for question number 8, true. The average person spends 3 hours and 9 minutes. Oh, Good job, Southside. You got close to 38. True. 3 hours. What are you guys doing in the toilet for that long? I don't want to know the answer. I don't want to know. Probably TikTok, but I don't want to know. True or false? 1 in 4 people drop their phones. It's false. It's actually 1 in 5. So it's a little bit better than I thought. But statistically, it's girls who drop their phones in the toilet more often than boys. So boys don't use a girl's phone. And then for 10, if you guessed greater than 30 seconds, like more than 30 seconds, you get a point. And if anybody put 60 seconds, we'll give them the point. But only if you put 60. Okay, and so you can have a maximum of 11 points. I doubt anybody is gonna get that, because like, this was very random. But I wanna know how much you got, because we have an awesome prize to give away that Peter's gonna announce. So if whoever is controlling the chat function, if you could drop how many points the highest person in the room got. So if you're by yourself, give me how much you got. So you're doing it. 6, is it pretty average? Okay, cool. That means that the UConn people definitely got one of their own questions wrong. Anyway, I wanna know who got the most, and if we have to, we will have a tie, but I'm really hoping, 7 from Mill Bay. I think that's the highest. But I'll keep watching that, and we will, White Horse, you tried with the Cherry Blasters. This was fun, even though I have no idea if you're even listening to me or if your leaders have muted me. I'd like to think that you didn't. I'd love to see you all in person one day and trust that we will get to see each other. Just not right now. Peter, you can shut me up now. It was fun, guys.
Thank you, Hannah. And Hannah's going to look through your responses and then she's going to send me a text with the highest one. So while I'm waiting for that, and then I'll announce what this awesome prize is going to be, I want to introduce you to our next amazing person who's going to join on. Hannah alluded to this, but her name is Louise Hannum, and she works with the Canadian Baptist Ministries, CBM, and she's been able to join us for quite a few serves and help us to understand what CBM is all about. Now, before she comes on, I just want to say that her official title on the website is Youth Engagement. And for someone who doesn't know better, that sounds like kind of like a matchmaking dating type service. So if you're interested in, if you're youth and you're interested in engagement, maybe she's the person for you. If that's not really what youth engagement means, maybe it's the other definition of engaging, which is making sure people care about someone. And so really what Louise does is amazing. She makes sure as best as she can that people care about youth. And that is an awesome job if I've ever heard an awesome job. So in just a second, I'm gonna invite Louise in. I'm just waiting from Hannah to text me with the highest total. And while I'm waiting for that, I'll tell you what the prize is. Whichever youth group, even if you're an individual playing along, if you're the highest, your youth group is going to get an awesome all expenses paid pizza party. Of course, it's youth group, it's gonna be pizza. And so we will make sure you get hooked up with some socially distant appropriate pizza, whatever that is. And you can eat it with long, I don't know, grab her hand things. All right, she needs more time figuring out a tiebreaker. How many, Hannah, how many? Well, she's gonna use the closest number to the candy as the tiebreaker. Who do you need to hear from, Hannah? Oh, we got White Rock guest 42, Westview guest 24. If you can help us out in the chat by writing out how many you guessed for the total number of candies. And then we will declare a winner for this pizza party. All right, well, it looks like we are going to have two winners tonight. which is fantastic. I believe, Hannah, are those the two highest totals? And they were both two off as well? Waiting for the confirmation. This is live streaming at its best. Isn't this exciting? Very exciting. Just waiting. Hannah, were the two that were two? Oh. Hannah texted me, YU0. Okay, she meant yes. Yes. All right, so we have White Rock and Southside. You will both be winning pizza parties. It'll just be half as much pizza as you would have won. Everybody can have half a slice of pizza. Now, we'll get you all hooked up with some awesome pizza. Thank you for playing. And now, without further ado, I want to welcome in Louise Hannum. Louise, I'm so glad that you're with us tonight, and I can't wait to hear from you all the way from the other coast. I'm here in Vancouver area, and she is literally on the other side of the country where it is, I don't know even how many hours ahead you are, like 34 hours. It's tomorrow already for Louise. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, it's Christmas here. It's almost 11 o'clock here, so it is past my bedtime, but there's nowhere that I would rather be than on this call with you guys. I wish I could see you all, but I do recognize a lot of names and youth group titles on here. So I hope that I've connected with a lot of you or most of you over the past couple of serves. And I too was so disappointed that we weren't able to gather in Whitehorse this year, but here we are today. And I've never been introduced as a matchmaker before. So that's not true. Although when I was a youth pastor, I did have a summer student and a visiting youth leader on a mission tour, actually, like serve. They did get engaged and they did end up getting married. So I'll add that to my resume. But I do have the best job in the world. As Peter said, I work with CBM, Canadian Baptist Ministries, which is your global mission partner. And it's my job to help you, your youth group or your church, connect with what God is doing around the world. And it was about a year ago that CBM decided to invest in a new way in youth, because we know that you, your generation, at your age, you know more about social issues and more about issues of justice and just generally more about what's happening around the world than any other generation has at your age. And that is incredible. And we think that you are absolutely incredible. And we think that you can make a difference in your own communities, but not just there, but you can make a difference globally in our world. And so CBM loves youth. We love your church. We love your youth group. And we want to help you engage with what God is doing. So we have lots of opportunities for you to do that. And I'd love to connect with you. We're doing everything online. So even though I'm in Halifax, I would love to show up at your youth group sometime here on Zoom and chat with you about that. Active in mission is one of those opportunities. And I know at least one youth group that engaged with this initiative. We had a ton of fun, and I'm going to attempt to share my screen here because I want to show you. Here it is. Oh, nope, not that one. Hopefully you can see this. This is our active in mission page right here. Our goal this year was to raise $15,000 to help build composting latrines in El Salvador. And you can see that we surpassed our goal. We more than doubled our goal thanks to individuals and churches and youth groups like yours, and some of you even on this call. We raised $31,462 to build 42 latrines. You know, Hannah's talking about how long we're in the bathroom and how much we drop our phone in the toilet. So on theme with that, composting toilets absolutely change lives. Here, toilet humor is funny, but it's really not that funny when you don't have a safe and sanitary place to use the washroom, and when you don't have that piece of dignity in your life, and when you're in danger, and when you're getting sick, and just all kinds of complications with not having a place to use the washroom, something that we all need, something that we all do. And so we've been raising money for this. And with all of the events canceled this spring and summer, we had to come up with a new way to help meet our budget for our latrines in El Salvador. And so we did active in mission. And so I want to say a huge thank you to the groups that have jumped on board with this. This is just an example of one way that you can engage in mission globally. One thing that you can do, whether you're in isolation or not, is be active in mission and fundraise online. So $31,462. I want to tell you really quickly about one other way that you can engage with us. This is our Be Sent website. And part of my job is to matchmake or engage youth groups in mission globally. And the other part of my job is to help you and your church actually travel cross-culturally to see, not just engage here in Canada with what God is doing around the world, but actually see firsthand, to learn from our brothers and sisters in Christ in a different context, to worship with them, to learn, and most of all, to listen, to have the posture of what it means to be a good listener and a learner, and to read scripture in another context, to see a new way of life and to see God at work there. And so that program is called SENT, which is our basically international mission component. So this is our website, besent.ca, and you will see that we list trips, and you will see that they only go until August 2020, and that one didn't even happen. Neither did this one in Brazil. So as we know, we can't travel right now, but that's okay, because we will be able to travel. And it actually takes most youth groups and most churches about 12 to 18 months to prepare for a cross-cultural mission experience. So this is a really great time for you and your youth group to start thinking about that. We customize these trips. They're certainly not cookie cutter trips that we just send group after group on, but we customize them so that they fit with the mission of your church and what our partners need around the world. So if you're interested in that, I would love to talk to you and to work with your group. It's a lot of preparation, a lot of learning and fundraising and work ahead of time. So this might be a good season to consider that. Last but not least, I just want to show you a couple pictures of El Salvador. So you can see, for those of you, there we go, for those of you who raised money for the latrines, this is, or if you're interested in the SEND trip, this is a group of students here from Atlanta, Canada, that I took to El Salvador in March. This is actually the last thing that I did before we stumbled upon a global pandemic. So this is a team of youth and leaders. And behind us, you'll see a composting latrine that we helped to build. So if you're interested in a SEND trip, I'd love to chat with you. If you're interested in more about the Latrines for Life project, I would also love to chat with you. And that might be a way that you can engage in this time where we can't travel as much. Thank you so much. I cannot wait until the next time that I'm able to come to the west coast of Canada and hang out with you. But in the meantime, I'm here, and I can be as close as Zoom if there's anything that I can help you with. So thanks so much. And Mill Bay, especially, I can't wait to see all of your pictures of active admission.
Louise, thank you so much for that. And I just want to reiterate how amazing it is that CVM has invested in a youth engagement, a full-time youth engagement staff person. What that means is that ultimately you have a missions organization that has a person whose job it is to serve you and partner with you and dream of where God might send you on mission. And one of the things I love, I've been a part of trips with Louise leading before, and she walks your group through an incredible process leading up to help you understand the culture, and also to help you understand that you're not going somewhere because you've got all the answers. You have a lot to learn, and we're going to partner. It's always about partnering with other Christians on the ground who are doing the work of God, walking alongside of them, supporting them, so that our presence when we go is one that brings life and brings the life of Christ to whatever community we go. And of course, we're changed along the way. So please do reach out to Louise. She'd love to chat with you. That isn't just lip service. She would love to chat with you. On more unfortunate news, we had an error in our accounting of the game. So I'm very sorry to do this, but Southside, that pizza party has been ripped away from you. I'm imagining there's crying, there's gnashing, there's weeping right now going on among those from Southside. But White Rock apparently was the rightful winner. And it'll be up to White Rock to see if they want to invite you to join them for their pizza party to share with you. But White Rock, you apparently are the rightful winner of the pizza party. So Southside, again, I am so sorry. But in better news than that, we have an opportunity to continue. This whole evening has been about worship. From everything we do is about worship. And we're going to continue in that with Fraser once again. So I welcome Fraser to come back and lead us into worship.
Thank you, Peter. I don't know, Peter, are you still there? Can you hear me? Can you come back on for a second? Peter, are you there? Oh, hey, Peter.
Hi.
Hey, is there any way we can like let the youth, like turn on the cameras for all the youth groups for these songs? Do you think, is that possible or is that?
You know what? I don't know if, okay, I'm gonna say this. Okay. If you have the ability to do so, go for it. I don't know if they have the ability to do that or not. So we'll let it happen if they can.
I know audio-wise it might be a bit of a mess, but like if we just see the video, it'd be kind of cool to see each other worshiping together.
I will work on that. And Fraser, I'll let you start and I will work on allowing everybody to start their video so we can see them all.
So before we go into the next section, I just want to officially introduce, I don't know if I actually said their names earlier, but right here, this is Michaela. And then over here, this is Amelia. She's quite short, but she's not that short. She's actually sitting on a drum right now. And we didn't try to wear the same colored shirt today, but obviously we're in tune with something. Anyway, we're so happy to be able to be here with you guys. And we're gonna try to, oh, there's a camera coming on. Hey everyone, how's it going? You can wave, there we are. Hi guys. Oh, look at all these cameras coming on, amazing. Very cool. So yeah, it's awesome to be here. The three of us have been to many serves. I don't even know how many I've been to now. More than Peter, I know that much. And Michaela, how many have you been to? Like,
I would say five.
Five, and Amelia's been to a few now. So it's just, it's so good to be with you guys. We love you guys very much. We love serving with you. And so we're gonna do a few more songs. We've had one added because of some requests on songs. So thank you for that. And we haven't practiced it, so we'll see how it goes. But even if it stinks, God still loves us and he likes our, hey guys, hey, look at all you guys. It's good to see everyone. Very cool. I don't feel alone anymore. That's great. Okay. I didn't even know if it was working the first two songs. We were just hoping that it was actually coming through. So anyway, let's worship. Let's sing Here I Am to Worship.
Only you came to the earth you created.
together wonderful to me. Search the heavens, search the stars. Thank you.
It's so great to be singing with you guys and to see you guys, and that makes it just a way cooler experience. We're going to do one more song. We saw it again. We saw it recommended or requested, and so someone said we have to do Light Up the Night, and I think we do have to do Light Up the Night, and I saw you guys' lights out there, so that's pretty cool. So maybe as you can have a little dance party for this last song as we go out with a bit of a bang. This song is called Light Up the Night. A little bit out of tune.
It's more than a little.
Yeah. We'll go with a bang, and thank you again for just singing with us and letting us come and worship with you guys. Let's sing loud.
Bye. takes my shame away. I'm gonna stay the same and I'm a killer.
Thank you guys again for having us, and thank you for worshiping with us, and we hope to see you very soon. God bless, and back to you, Peter.
Fraser, thank you so much for that. Yeah, it is amazing to watch these screens everywhere of people just worshiping wherever you are right now. So thank you for that. I'm still seeing your screen, Fraser. Are you seeing me?
Yeah, sorry, I'll close off.
Okay.
Hi, everyone.
Okay, well, hopefully you are all seeing me. I want to thank you for being a part of this this live stream tonight. This was kind of an experiment to see how it would go. We wanted to bring a little serve to you wherever you are, and it's been really sweet. As promised, I want to share with you some photos. You've used the hashtag #ServeAtHome2020. If you haven't posted it yet, you have like 30 seconds to get on your phone or your device and post your photos from serving today with the hashtag #ServeAtHome2020. We'll bring that up here. Just look at a few photos of you guys serving today. Here we got some pizza going on in Mill Bay. Fort St. John's. Congratulations, finishing a 10K with a poop emoji, which is, and a little toilet. That is a great prize for helping build some latrines. That's beautiful. Well, I don't know if beautiful is the right word, but that's pretty appropriate, I should say. Here's a group out doing a 10K walk. I hope, well, I'm looking at the color of that paint. It looks gray, so I'm thinking this is a before photo. Let's see what we have. Hey, there you go. Look at that. I hope the people that you were painting knew that you were doing that. Well, maybe not. Maybe it was a surprise for them. That's great. Top down, see if we've got. Nice. Cleaning up a garden of some kind. Nice strawberry. Let's see, we got a few more to get through here. Westview, well done. You packed a bunch of backpacks. 32 backpacks for families who need them. Well done. This is from Emmanuel. They did a car wash a while ago, and even the police got a nice wash for their cars, which is pretty awesome. So I think looking through, I think we've hit all of those. Thank you once again for sharing. Thank you for posting those photos, and continue. If you haven't posted them yet, please do, because we can all see them together. As we finish off, I just want to share one thing with you. I'm reflecting on what COVID has meant to all of us, and you know, we hear a lot about that, but the reality is it's pretty easy for us, and maybe not easy is the right word, but it's simpler sometimes to hide what's going on inside, because we're struggling. There's so many people struggling right now. And I'll give you an example right now of sometimes I think the way that we live. What you see right here is this nice sign here. Well, I hope it's nice. And that's a blue wall. But if you look around here, I'll turn you around. This is a messy playroom, a very messy playroom with a exposed light bulb right here. And I'm wearing shorts, but I won't show you that. The reality is for so many of us that Jesus even points this out, that sometimes we clean the outside of the dish when the inside is all dirty. And I'll leave you with this. if you're struggling right now and people don't know it, you know it, you're really struggling right now, talk to someone, whether it be someone in your youth group, talk to someone at your church, a pastor, a friend, talk to someone. Don't struggle through this alone. I know this period can be quite isolating. You think maybe I'm the only one going through this. I promise you, you're not. So if you are struggling, please do talk to someone, because as the body of Christ, we're meant to serve one another and walk through some of these difficult things together. And that's one of the reasons why I was so excited for this event, because it gave us an opportunity to serve together, which is something we just haven't been able to do a whole lot of over the last few months. I want to give you a brief update for Serve 2021. Brief update, there isn't a whole lot to say, except we are going to be having a serve. It is going to look different. Planning is challenging, to say the least, during this time. We are going to serve is probably going to look a little bit different, but we're moving forward with Serve for 2021. And all of those details, we're going to release those over the next couple of months. So this fall, we got a team working on it. It's going to look a little different, but we are going to make sure that we are going to be able to serve next summer, and in a way that we're going to try to plan it in a way that it won't need to be postponed. We're going to set it up in a way that it can go forward. So be excited for that. And I want to thank you. Well, I do want to thank you for coming, but I also want to say thank you to Fraser and team, and Steve and Louise and Hannah, and for joining us, being a part of this Serve live stream. I'm so excited that you got to join us here this evening. And as we close, I want to thank our Lord and Savior, because without Christ, we have nothing. And so as we close out this evening, I'd ask you to pray with me. Lord Jesus, we serve because of you. You've laid the example for us. You gave up your life for us so that we could have life. And as we pour out our lives for others, we're reflecting that sacrifice, Lord. As we serve without asking anything in return, we're modeling for people the selfless love and sacrifice that you've given, and the good news. I thank you for that. I pray that as we look at our world around us, we would see opportunities to serve you and serve our neighbor everywhere. That even if it needs to be more creative, that we wouldn't be scared by COVID, that we'd be safe, but we'd look for those opportunities. We'd look for them and we'd take them. We serve one another in a way that brings life and brings people closer to you. Be with us now, God, as we all go our separate ways. Thank you that we could have this gift of technology, a way to connect across provinces. We pray this in your name. Amen. Thank you all for being here. Really, really glad to have worshiped with you, to have served at home. And if you need to be in touch, please do. Good night.
I remember the night back in late November. I was out in the cold. I was alone praying for answers. The storm was loud, but it couldn't tell me nothing. The fire was wild, but it just left me struggling. You're moving the stillness, you're moving the stillness. Closing the distance, now I can feel it. Now I can feel you. Ooh, wow. Your voice isn't hidden, your voice isn't hidden.